Hey everyone, it's Juna with Detour Shirts. In this video, I'm gonna talk about Placeit and some of the tips and tricks that I just recently learned for print on demand on Placeit. I've been using it in a different way before, but now there's some other things that I think can really help you with print on demand and find you more things that you probably never found before. So at least for me, that's what it worked for. So I'm gonna try and share with you these tips and tricks in under 10 minutes as well. So lots to get to here. So let's get into Placeit right now and I'll show you everything that I learned recently. All right, so here we are on Placeit, placeit.net. This is where you start. And if you're like me, the thing that you would do, thing I do is I come in here and I just search mockups, and that's what I use it for. I almost never just stop on here. And so my first tip is the homepage. There's lots of good things on the homepage. There's things that I didn't realize that they curate this. You notice you got Cinco de Mayo because it's coming up, and Mother's Day and things like that, because these are the things that are current right now. And so these are the things that they think that you may need and want. So tip one, don't miss out on the homepage. Tip two, I didn't realize there's actually a creator's pick as part of these things. So I'm gonna click on here. You can see 126 different ones. Some really cool stuff, some new stuff, but also some things that the creators like you and I are saying these are some of the best things, so that it's curated as well. So this one, I didn't realize they have that. Look how cool this is. This t-shirt design, really cool, 70s. Some really cool 70s or retro designs here you can use as mock-ups and so on. So love this spot. Some things that I probably wouldn't get by just searching. So creators picks, really cool on the homepage. The next one I'm gonna talk about, tip number three, is Mother's Day. And I know it's part of here and we talked about this, but Mother's Day is a special one because if you click on here, you'll notice that there's even more things on here. So you can browse t-shirts. Not all of the ones that were on there do this. They have kind of this drop down here. I mean, this one has this drop down, but the other ones don't have this drop down. You can just look at Mother's Day t-shirts. Check that out. Or you can come in here and say, oh, I actually want to do a Mother's Day Instagram post. Boom. Right? So it has, there's so much in this Mother's Day one that they kind of filtered it down so you can see what to do. T-shirts again. And if you can do Instagram and t-shirts, or you can kind of, these are multi-select check boxes, right? So you can do offers and so on and so on. All right, back to Placeit. This is the homepage. The other thing on the homepage, besides this top row of really cool things that get curated, there's also new templates. So this is tip number four, new templates. You can click on here. You can see it changes to fingers here. So 137 new templates. And again, you can look through here and see some of the cool designs. Now this is a really cool design. They have t-shirt designs as well as mock-ups, which you may not have known, but you can look at all these pages of stuff. So you can come in here and go through it all. Some really cool ones here for things coming up, as well as school graduations coming up as well. So really cool stuff. So I would suggest go through here. And again, you can filter these down and look at some of the things right here. Tip number five has to do with the t-shirt design. So I'm gonna go in mockups, print on demand, t-shirts, just like that. So this is the way you get there. And you notice these are all the mockups for t-shirt design. What you may not have known is that you can use all these drop-downs for it. So first the drop-down up here, let's say you just want a crew neck t-shirt. Boom, so you'll notice everybody here has a crew neck now. And you can filter it even more. So you can filter it by gender, man, woman, girl. Let's just do man for now, right? So now all of these are men if you're looking for a man. If you want it age specific, you can do adult, kid, senior. Let's say I'm doing an older t-shirt, boom, right? For Father's Day or something like that, easily. Filtered it down, now it's only 16 pages, and you can even do it by ethnicity. So let's say I wanna look for a Hispanic dad. Boom, check that out. Really cool, right? And you can filter it even more. So this is the drop-downs is a tip, but you can also filter it by these filters right here. So this is tip number six, is to go to the filters as well. So I got crew neck right here, but I can also look at maybe fitness, or I could look at indoors instead of outdoors, right? And so on. So you can see it also adds it right here. So let's say, oh, okay, maybe I don't want a man. I just want everybody, any Hispanic model. I bring in the women too, or I don't want it age specific. Let me unfilter that and so on. So tip number 7, which you might not have known, is you can come back to the homepage and go to design, apparel and print, t-shirt design. We're gonna go to t-shirt designs. I got a ton of them and you can use the same thing. So t-shirt designs, let's say I'm looking for a specific animal, maybe just cat designs, boom. Here are all the cat designs. Now they have a ton, look at that, 37 pages of cat designs. So you can mix and match these. You can actually change out the text and stuff. I may wanna do a video later. Let me know in the comments if you wanna see a video on how to design in Placeit, but they have a full design suite here. But again, you can use the dropdowns here as well as the dropdowns here by saying popular, best-selling, newest. So the next few tips are gonna be tips on searches that I don't usually use, but I found that they're very helpful. So the first one I think is, I'm just gonna type in Japanese. So just type in Japanese here and hit search. Now again, you can use the filters here, but look at some of these cool Japanese t-shirt designs and mock-ups. Just really cool. So these may not be the ones that you've looked for, but I think they're really cool. I noticed some of these, like this one and this one, are some really cool designs as well as some really cool mock-ups, right? The next one that I wanna share with you is anime. Speaking of Japanese, you can also do anime. And there's some really cool anime mock-ups and designs. So there's some designs, but you can also use them as videos and as well as mock-ups. So you can see, look at these, really cool. But there's also some mock-ups that you may not have known. If you go here, you can just look at mock-ups and you have to hit search. So now it's searching for mock-ups in anime. Isn't this cool? You can put your t-shirt designs on some of these anime mock-ups, which is really cool. The next one that I want to search on is GTA, which is Grand Theft Auto. I'm going to hit search on here. So you can see some really cool Grand Theft Auto inspired designs. So you can come in here, change out the words. Mock-ups are really cool too. Some like really cool artwork for GTA. I've shown some of these on social media, but I think these are a different style than the anime. Still illustrative, but really, really cool. So the next search is 80s right here. I'm gonna type in 80s. And there's some really cool stuff in here. We saw this before. I think these are really funny if you're looking for some humor or some throwback things. If you've designed some 80s designs and want to put them on mock-ups, you also have these kinds of 80s, you know, anime kind of things as well. But I love these right here too. It's like some 80s retro with the lights and everything. So 80s is a good search. Again, remember you can use these drop-downs right here. The next one is 3D. So you may not have known about this one, 3D. I'm just gonna do 3D, hit enter, and show you some 3D stuff. Check this out. I love the 3D mock-ups too. So just another version of mock-ups. I'm gonna go mock-ups and hit search. Some really cool mock-ups for your t-shirts, right? Can you imagine your design on some of these mock-ups? Also some really cool video, 3D video mock-ups that I think will do really well on Reels or social media. Check that out. That would be really cool if you're doing this kind of stuff. So this is the last one that I'm going to share with you, and this is retro. So kind of like 80s, but even more retro. So here's some retro designs that pulls up. Again, with the kaiju stuff, I think this is really cool. But you can also do retro mock-ups. So I'm going to come here and do mock-ups and hit search. And then here's how you find some of these retro stuff. So you got even more things, like it goes really retro, not just the 80s retro, but even further back kind of retro. And you got 14 pages. So I'm gonna show you some of these. I love this one, which is not 80s, this is more like 70s. This is a really cool mock-up. And some diner stuff and cool like that. So you can also type any of the years in there, 80s, 70s, 60s, but I think retro kind of captures a lot of the other stuff. So you got grunge, retro, 80s retro and 70s retro and things like that. So hopefully that's really helpful for you. So I think we did it under 10 minutes. Those are some of my tips and tricks that I learned at Placeit. Placeit is always changing and making things better. But come on here, remember the homepage. This is going to change by next month for things that are coming up. And there's always going to be new templates here. So hopefully this was really helpful for you. Try all of these out. Find something that works for you that can help you with your print on demand. So there you go. Those are my Placeit tips and tricks for right now. Things that I just found out. And I think these can be really helpful for you, especially with design. If you want to see more on how to create designs in Placeit, let me know in the comments. Maybe I can do a video on how to create a design in Placeit, because there's so many templates and you can use fonts and things like that. And if you want to see how to use Placeit for PLD, I just made this video right here. I'm going to put it right there. And you can see all the different things that I think can be really helpful for PLD too. Not only the things that I showed you, but a lot more. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.